Hey everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Bio e-Content. Today we are exploring the amazing world of DNA, the molecule that makes us who we are. My name is Dr. Sanjay. In today's session, we are going to learn what exactly is DNA. What is the importance and role of DNA in growth and development of any living organisms? What is the basis of character transmission? How the characters are transferred from parents to children? For example, eye color, face shape, height, blood type, etc. What do you think? Who has gifted such traits to you? Either mom or your dad. In this video, we are going to learn the structure and functions of DNA. It's my opinion, each and every student from the science faculty must know the structure and functions of the DNA. Let's talk about the double helix. That is DNA. Or in simple word, you can call deoxyribonucleic acid, which carries the genetic information essential for the growth, development, functioning, and reproduction of all living organisms. You can think of it as the ultimate instructions for the development of the characters, as we discussed earlier. What do you think? How the organs of your body get developed? Either you should have five fingers in your hand or six. What should be the exact location of your eyes? Either below forehead or on your shoulder. Think of it. Is it interesting? I hope everyone is enthusiastic to learn about such things, that is DNA, right? Well, let's talk about the structure of DNA. You can see here the picture of DNA or deoxyribonucleic acid. It consists of long two strands, coil around each other. One is moving from 5 prime to 3 prime direction, and another strand is moving in opposite to the first one, that is from 5 prime to 3 prime direction, like this. Now, by seeing this picture, we have to understand what DNA is made up of. As the picture clearly says, DNA is made up of these three things. That is, one is phosphate group, which is the backbone. Second one is sugar, that is the deoxyribose sugar. And third one is a nitrogenous bases. The nitrogenous bases are of four types. Okay. T, G, C. A stands for adenine, T stands for thymine, G stands for guanine, and C stands for cytosine. These nitrogenous bases will be arranged in this fashion. A will always pair with the T, that is adenine will always pair with thymine, and G will always pair with C. Now, after getting the knowledge of these three components, as we discussed, the DNA is made up of polynucleotide. Here we discussed each nucleotide is having a three component. One is phosphate group, second is sugar, and third one is nitrogenous bases. As you can see here, these are the two strands of the DNA made up of nucleotides. Many nucleotides comes together to make a DNA. Now, each and every nucleotide is having three components. One is, out of three, the first one is pentose sugar. It's having five carbon sugar. And the sugar in the DNA is in the form of deoxyribose. Second component is phosphate group. You can see here, this is the phosphate group, which is important to link the sugar on one nucleotide onto the phosphate of the next nucleotide. Third component of the nucleotide is nitrogenous bases. As we have discussed, these are the four bases, A, T, G, C, which are arranged in a fixed manner. You can see the nitrogenous bases will be arranged like this. A will always pair with T with two hydrogen bond, and a G, that is guanine, will always pair with the C having three hydrogen bond. And this is the backbone of DNA made up of sugar and phosphate group. One sugar molecule is get linked with the phosphate group. That phosphate group is again joined with the sugar group. Likewise, the backbone is made up of. This is the one strand of DNA, and this is the second strand made up of these three components: sugar, phosphate, and nitrogenous bases. Next is the functions of DNA. You must be interested to know what are the different functions of DNA. What is the exact role of DNA? How it gives the instructions to synthesize the characters like your eye color, height, blood type, etc. We'll see one by one. The first function of DNA is it stores the genetic information in the form of these four letters only, A, T, G, C. And all living organisms are made up of these four bases only. There is no boundary of living organism. That is, one is made up of these four letters. That is human being. And the bacteria is made up of a different one. Nothing like that. From bacteria to huge organism is made up of DNA, and that DNA is of made up of four letters, A, T, G, C. Likewise, the DNA is stored in the form of these four letters. You can see here the sequencing of your you can take the example of any living organism, go for the sequencing, and you will have such sequence the genome. Second function of the DNA is DNA guides for the protein production. As I said, the eye color is one of the traits. But how that eye color will get expressed? Something must be there behind it, and that is the gene. The gene must be functional to synthesize a particular protein, that is required for the eye color. But for that, three bases are important to make a one codon. Out of four nitrogenous bases, three will get paired in this fashion, either GCU, ACG, AAG. 64 codons are responsible for making the 20 essential amino acids. You can see here the first group of codon, that is GCU, is responsible for alanine. Likewise, in this picture also, you can understand the genetic information or genetic instructions are sent by the DNA to RNA, and the RNA again send some instructions for the production of protein. The third and most important function is DNA passes the traits to the next generation, that is, from parents to offspring. Some dominant characters are also there. As we discussed, the brown eye is one of the dominant characters. Either brown-eyed is your mom or your dad. But the brown eye will get expressed in child, either it is daughter or son. The 50% characters from mother and 50% characters from father will get transferred to the children. The upper limit to get transferred the character is 50% only, not above the 50% character will get transferred. And the fourth function of the DNA is DNA has the repairing mechanism. Nowadays we are seeing the many cases of cancers. Cancers are only because of the happens during the DNA replication. If your body is sound, that those DNAs responsible for the cancerous cells production will get repaired automatically. But when your body is sound, you are taking the good diet, you are doing the exercises daily, then and then only the replication, DNA replication will get accurately. You can see here, what are the factors for the breakage of DNA? Or disturbances may come because of which things? It may be radiations, it may be chemicals, or it may be UV light. Naturally, that DNA, a broken DNA or error DNA will get repaired likewise. And the particular amino acids will get synthesized. You can see here also, the broken DNA will get repaired naturally. This is all about the DNA structure and function. Learners, I am happy to share the information about the DNA structure and functions. I hope you may like this video and subscribe for the upcoming videos based on the science. Thank you. Based on the science.